This podcast will review anaerobic and aerobic respiration. You should recall that glycolysis provides the cell two ATP, two NADH, and two pyruvates per glucose. If the cell is in anaerobic conditions, meaning without oxygen gas, they will switch to a fermentation pathway. Fermentation will not provide any additional ATP for the cell. The cell will simply gain 2 ATP per glucose from glycolysis. However, NAD plus levels will be depleted within the cell performing glycolysis unless the NADH molecules can be recycled. This is accomplished by fermentation. During fermentation, the pyruvates produced during glycolysis are converted by enzymes to either lactic acid or into carbon dioxide and ethanol, depending on which enzymes the cell possesses. Simultaneously, NADH will be oxidized or changed back into the NAD plus form. You might recall that NAD plus is very important to the redox reaction in glycolysis that we discussed at length. If a cell is within an environment with oxygen gas, the cell will use aerobic respiration. This occurs in the mitochondria. The pyruvates made in glycolysis are transported into the mitochondria via active transport. The cost is 1 ATP per pyruvate. Once inside, the pyruvate molecules undergo a transition or preparatory reaction in which an NADH molecule is produced once again, as well as a carbon dioxide. After this reaction, the product feeds into the citric acid cycle, formerly known as the Krebs cycle. All the enzymatic conversions of the citric acid cycle produce 3 more NADH, 1 more ATP, 1 more FADH2, and 2 more carbon dioxides per initial pyruvate. To relate our numbers back to our glucose molecules, we double it all. The high-energy NADH and FADH2 are used in the electron transport system, ETS for short, located in the mitochondrial membrane. NADH and FADH2 serve as the electron donors to the electron transport system. If you remember, the first stage of an ETS is to take an electron and pass it like a hot potato to other members of the ETS. The final electron acceptor is oxygen, which is the reason we physically breathe. We need to supply the oxygen to the ETS and the mitochondria. While the electron is being passed along from member to member, hydrogen ions are being pumped across the membrane to build a gradient. In the second phase, the hydrogen ion gradient flows back across the membrane through a channel made by a protein. The flow of ions powers the protein and enables it to perform a coupling reaction between ADP and phosphate to produce ATP. For every NADH that starts the process, we gain 3 ATP. For every FADH2 that donates its electrons, we will gain 2 ATP. If you sit down and do the simple addition and multiplication, you will calculate, as we did in class, the aerobic respiration that couples glycolysis to the citric acid cycle and the electron transport chain in the mitochondria will produce 36 ATP per glucose. This obviously is far better than the 2 from anaerobic conditions. Hope this clarifies some of the mysteries of metabolism, or catabolism to be specific. See you next time!